Hello everyone. Today we'll discuss about the liver. The liver is the largest gland of the body. It consists of both endocrine and the exocrine parts. It is the second largest organ of the body. In adult male, it weighs around 1.4 to 1.8 kgs. In female, it weighs around 1.2 to 1.4 kgs. And at birth, it is only 150 grams. The liver occupies the whole of the right hypochondrium, the upper part of the epigastrium, and the left hypochondrium till the left lateral plane. As we can see, the liver is wedge-shaped organ. It consists of five surfaces and one well-demarcated border. Now we'll see the surfaces. This is the anterior surface. This is the superior surface. This is the right lateral surface. And this is the posterior surface and inferior surface. It consists of a prominent inferior border, as we can see here. In the inferior border, there is cystic notch that we can see here, and there will be interlobar notch. See. So, liver consists of five surfaces and one well demarcated border. The surfaces are superior surface, anterior surface, right lateral surface, posterior surface, and inferior surface. And there is well demarcated inferior border that separates anteriorly the anterior border from the anterior surface from the inferior surface, and on the right side it separates the right lateral surface from the inferior surface. Now coming to the anatomical lobe of the liver. The anatomical lobe of the liver is the right lobe and the left lobe. It is separated from each other by three ligaments. Namely, anteriorly there will be the falciform ligament. Then, posteriorly there will be the ligamentum venosum. And inferiorly, there will be the ligamentum teres. So, the liver is anatomically separated or divided into two lobes by three ligaments. Anteriorly by the falciform ligament. Posteriorly by the ligamentum venosum and inferiorly by the ligamentum teres into a larger, as we can see here, a huge mass is here. So, a larger right lobe and a smaller left lobe. The right lobe is approximately 5/6 part and the left lobe consists of 1/6 part of the liver. The right lobe of the liver consists of five surfaces: anterior surface, superior surface, right lateral surface, then there will be posterior surface and inferior surface. But the left lobe consists of anterior surface, superior surface and posterior surface and inferior surface. The right lobe consists of two additional lobes. That is, we can see on the posterior surface there will be caudate lobe, and on the inferior surface there will be quadrate lobe. See? So now we will see the boundaries of the caudate lobe. The boundaries of the caudate lobe. So this is the left side and this is the right side. On the right side there will be groove for the inferior vena cava. Then on the left side there will be fissure for the ligamentum venosum. Then superiorly there will be the superior surface, and inferiorly there will be the porta hepatis. We'll discuss about the porta hepatis after some time. So the caudate lobe is located on the posterior surface, okay, and on the right side there will be the groove for the inferior vena cava, and on the left side there will be the fissure for the ligamentum venosum. Superiorly, there will be the superior border or the superior surface, and inferiorly there will be the border hairpins. Now coming to the quadrate law. See, this is the quadrate law. You can see this is the quadrate law. Okay. On the then on liver is like this, right? It will be like this. Anatomical position will be like this. So if it is like this, then the quadrate law anteriorly will be the porta hepatis and posteriorly will be the inferior border. Now on the right side there will be the fossa for the gallbladder, and on the left side there will be the fissure for the ligamentum teres. So quadrate lobe is in the inferior surface. It is bounded anteriorly by the porta hepatis, posteriorly by the inferior border. On the right side there will be fossa for the gallbladder, and on the left side there will be groove for the ligamentum teres. In addition to it, the caudate lobe consists of two processes. See this one, which is directed towards the inferior surface. This is the inferior surface. The process which is related to the right lobe is known as the caudate process, and on the left side is the papillary process. Now the caudate lobe consists of anterior surface and posterior surface. Anterior surface is formed by the, it is related to the posterior wall of the ligamentum venosum, and the posterior surface is related to the floor of the groove of the vertebral column. Now we will see the porta hepatis. The porta hepatis, this part, it is the transverse non-peritoneal fissure and acts as a gateway of the liver. It extends from the neck of the gallbladder, to the fissure for the ligamentum teres and the venosum. So it is a transverse non-peritoneal fissure that extends from the neck of the gallbladder to the fissure for the ligamentum teres and ligamentum venosum. It acts as a gateway of the liver. A gateway means some structures will enter through it and some structures will leave the liver through it. The structures entering into the liver are the right and the left branches of the hepatic artery, right and the left divisions of the portal vein, the hepatic plexus of nerves. And the structures that leave the porta hepatis are right and the left hepatic ducts, cystic duct and the lymphatics. Now we will see the structures. So this is the right side, this is the left side, and it intervenes between the posterior surface and the inferior surface, right? Inferiorly there will be gallbladder. So this is the inferior surface, this is the posterior surface. So before backwards, the structures in the porta hepatis are, this is the duct, these are arteries, and this is the vein. See, duct that is draining, see this is connected to the gallbladder duct, and this is the artery, and this is the portal vein. So the porta hepatis, it acts as a gateway, and some structures will enter through it and some will exit. So the structures entering are, grossly there will be hepatic artery, portal vein and the nerve plexus. And the structures that will leave the porta hepatis, leave the liver through the porta hepatis, are the ducts, the lymphatics. Now the physiological lobe of the liver. The physiological lobe is also consists of the right lobe and the left lobe, but the demarcation is different. Why? The physiological lobe, the right physiological lobe and the left physiological lobe are supplied respectively by the left right and the left branches of the portal vein and the hepatic artery, and the bile of the respective lobes is conveyed by the corresponding hepatic ducts. This division is it has some surgical importance. Now the line of demarcation we'll see. Inferiorly, it is through the floor of the or the fossa of the gallbladder, then through the groove of the inferior vena cava. See, groove of the inferior vena cava, fossa of the gallbladder, then through the groove of the inferior vena cava. Then anteriorly, it will extend a little right to the falciform ligament, like this. Okay, so anteriorly, a little right to the falciform ligament, then posteriorly will be through the inferior vena cava, and inferiorly through the fossa of the gallbladder. This line divides the liver into two physiological lobes, that is the right lobe and the left lobe. Now we will see the peritoneal relations. Before seeing the peritoneal relations, we will see the peritoneal reflections. This is the falciform ligament. The falciform ligament is attached anteriorly to the anterior abdominal wall and the umbilicus, and then it is attached to the anterior surface of the liver. It then divides into right layer and the left layer. The left layer covers the left lobe anteriorly, superiorly, posteriorly and inferiorly, and then it forms the left triangular ligament. So the left layer is covering the anterior surface, the superior surface, the posterior surface and the inferior surface of the left lobe, and forms the left triangular ligament. Now coming to the right layer. The right layer covers the anterior surface of the right lobe, the superior surface and the right lateral surface, and here it forms the superior layer of the coronary ligament. It inferiorly, the right layer also covers the inferior surface, and here it forms the inferior layer of the coronary ligament. The superior layer and the inferior layer of the coronary ligament unites and forms the right triangular ligament. So what we can see, the right, in the right lobe, the right layer is covering the anterior surface, the superior surface and the right lateral surface, and forming, and it is continuous with the superior layer of the coronary ligament, and inferiorly it covers the inferior surface and forms and is continuous with the inferior layer of the coronary ligament. Now the superior layer and the inferior layer of the coronary ligament merge with each other and forms a right triangular ligament. Now what happens? Now this layer, this peritoneal reflection, this will cover the inferior vena cava and the lips of the porta hepatis, and it will end in the fissure for the ligamentum venosum. So what we can see, that the liver is almost entirely covered by the peritoneum, except here. This area between the superior layer of the coronary ligament and the inferior layer of the coronary ligament, and here on the right side, the right triangular ligament, this area is known as the bare area of the liver. Now this is one non-peritoneal area. And one we have already seen, the porta hepatis, the gateway. So the porta hepatis is non-peritoneal. This groove, okay, this groove for IVC, it is also non-peritoneal. And the floor of the fissures, the floor of the fissures, that is the fissure for the ligamentum venosum and the fissure for the ligamentum teres, these are the non-peritoneal areas. Now, in addition to it, anteriorly, another small area is seen over the cardiac impression due to divergence of the layers of the falciform ligament here. Okay, when the falciform ligament is divided into right layer and the left layer, here will be one bare area. This is the peritoneal relations of the liver. Now we will see the visceral relations of the liver. We will start with the superior surface. The superior surface is accurately molded with the under surface of the vault of the diaphragm. So, on both sides it is related with the diaphragm. Now, coming to the lateral surface, the right lateral surface. The right lateral surface, there will be the under surface of the right part of the diaphragm, and it is related to the 7th to the 11th ribs of the right side. Okay, so superiorly there will be diaphragm, it is related to the diaphragm, and right lateral side also, right side of the diaphragm is related to it, and the 7th to the 8th ribs of the right side. Now coming to the anterior surface. Now, anterior surface, we will study right part, left part and intermediate part. Okay. Now, anteriorly, what we can see, this is a larger portion. So, the right part, it lies beneath the right costal margin and it is related with the diaphragm and 6th to 10th ribs of the right side. Okay. So, 6th to 10th ribs of the right side and the related to the diaphragm. Now the left part lies beneath the left costal margin and it is related with the diaphragm again and the 7th and 8th left costal cartilage. Now coming to the intermediate part. The intermediate part, anteriorly, it will be in contact with the xiphoid process. Now we will see the visceral relations of the posterior surface. For the posterior surface, we will see it from the right to the left side. All the features we will see and the visceral relations. Okay, now from the right side. First we have seen here is the bare area. Okay, so bare area, in the apex of the bare area is the right triangular ligament. Base will be the groove of the IVC and superiorly and inferiorly by the respective layers of the coronary ligament. This bare area is related with the diaphragm and it is related with the part of the right suprarenal gland. Okay. Now what is the next feature? Next feature is the groove of the IVC. The groove of the IVC, we can see what? It is related to the inferior vena cava. Then is the caudate lobe. The caudate lobe, we have seen it has anterior surface and the posterior surface. And the caudate lobe is related with the right crux of the diaphragm, above the aortic opening and the right inferior phrenic artery. Okay, now next will be the next, here we can see this is the fissure for the ligamentum venosum. So in the ligamentum venosum fissure, there will be the lodgment of the ligamentum venosum. Now what is ligamentum venosum? Ligamentum venosum, it is the remnant of the ductus venosus of the fetal life. Now, slight left to it, there will be the groove for esophagus here. Here will be the esophagus. It is related to the abdominal part of the esophagus. So, this is about the posterior surface relations. Though, so we'll recap once. For the posterior surface, the features are, first will be the bare area, then the groove for the IVC, then there will be the caudate lobe, then there will be the fissure for the ligamentum venosum and there will be groove for the esophagus. Okay, now we will see the relations in the inferior surface. See, inferior surface. Inferior surface we will see from the right, from the left to the right side. Sorry, from the left to the right side. Okay. First, there will be, we can see the gastric impression. Okay. This is the gastric impression. So, it will be related to the fundus and the body of the stomach. Then we can see this part. This is the fissure for the ligamentum teres. So, there will be lodgment of the ligamentum teres hepatis, which is the remnant of the obliterated left umbilical vein. And then right to it will be the quadrate lobe. Okay. Quadrate lobe is crossed by the pyloric part of the stomach and first part of the duodenum. After the caudate lobe, we can see here is the pota hepatis. We have discussed about the pota hepatis. Okay. So there will be gastric impression first, then there will be the fissure for ligamentum teres, then there will be the pota hepatis, and after that we have seen the processes, the papillary and the caudate process of the caudate lobe. Okay. Now there will be the fossa for the gallbladder and it is related to the gallbladder. Now, right to the gallbladder, there will be three impressions: the duodenal impression, the colic impression, and the renal impression. In the duodenal impression, here it is related to the second part of the duodenum, and the colic impression here it will be related to the right colic flexure, and this larger portion, this is the renal impression. And it will be related to the upper part of the right kidney, I mean anterior surface of the upper part of the right kidney. So, we will recap once the inferior surface characteristics. So, from the left to the right side, there will be gastric impression. Then there will be fissure for the ligamentum teres. There will be caudate lobe. There will be pota hepatis. There will be the caudate and the papillary process. There will be fossa for the gallbladder, and then there will be duodenal impression, colic impression, and the renal impression. So this is the visceral relations of the liver. Now with the visceral relations, we have completed the gross anatomy of the liver. Hope you have enjoyed the video and also understood the gross anatomy of the liver.